But I get weirded out by shit, you know? Like, I remember when I had my first apartment by myself, like, single, got, like, nobody else lived there. So, of course, bachelor pad, first thing I called phone sex. They were so creeped out by that. It wasn't fucking yesterday, all right? It was a lot of years before, you know, like, I still had dial-up at that point, you know? But it's just, you know, like, it's, you know, you, yeah, you call up and it's just, it's, like, I didn't realize, like, you know, I'm like, oh, I gotta talk too. I can't do that shit. Like, if I could do that, there'd be a real girl here. And they get on there, they're like, press 1 for a buxom blonde, press 2 for a hot brunette, press 3 to join a party line, and you can join or just listen in. I'm like, all right, I can press 3 and be a fucking weirdo. And I'm looking at 3 like, it's a big line to cross, isn't it? But I'm doing it because, I mean, you know, it's my first apartment with my own, you know, the phone bill. I'm the only one who sees the phone bill. So it's not like I have a roommate. So you're going to go, did you make a $600 phone call the other day? Yeah, I thought my buddy's area code was 900 and I fucked it up. I hit 3. There's just a guy and a girl going to talk back. He's, you know, and she's like, yeah, you horny baby? He's like, yeah, I'm horny, bitch. I'm like, dude. I'm like, whoa, be nice. Like, I don't want to be on his team. I'm just sitting there quiet, listening to him go back and forth. You know, yeah, babe, yeah. I'm like a fucking 10-year-old, you know. And I hear he's like, yeah, you like that? She's like, yeah, I like it. And she's like, are you going to come? He's like, yeah, I'm going to come. She's like, I want you to come inside me. And I'm like, and I snapped. I'm like, whoa, you barely fucking know this guy. And it was the first thing I said. And they're like, hey, who's that? And I'm like, oh, shit, is Bill there? Fuck, I had the wrong number for the past 22 minutes. I can't do this. I can't get into stuff like that. Like, I get weirded out. Like, I'm one of those guys who thinks too. Like, I can't say I've never had a one-night stand. It just wasn't my call. Like, I just wasn't invited back, you know? I mean, but I'm still one of those guys, like, I never think in terms of today. Like, I don't, you know, I think too far in advance. Like, I remember I had a girl, it was after a show here a few years ago, like, this was a hot chick, comes up to me after a show, you know, she's like, I want to hang out with you tonight. Where are you going? I looked down. She had a tattoo on her boob of a dude's name that wasn't mine. And I just can't think in terms of that. I'm like, that's going to fucking bother me eventually. My mom's not going to like that shit at all. Unless you remove that boob or I change my name to fucking Malik, that's going to bug the shit out of me. So it's not going to work out. But I get weirded out by something. My wife, like, after we've been together for a while, like, it took her a while. She finally asked me one night, like, she's like, how come you're so quiet when we have sex? How come you don't make more noise when we have sex? I'm like, I guess because I'm not really used to there being another person. Right? Like, I wasn't really trying to draw a crowd up to this point, I guess. I'm like, do you really want me to make more noise? Listen to my voice. What's going to come out of here that's going to make this shit hotter, you know? Like, oh, yeah, that's fucking sweet, baby. Like, you don't... This is good for telling jokes, but it'll dry your shit up quick in the dark. Like, you don't... I shut the fuck up during sex. But she put me on the spot one night, though. We're having sex. She's like, come on, talk dirty. It'll be fun. I'm like, shut up. Like, it won't be fun, it'll be weird. Because nothing I say is going to sound cool. Some guys can say shit and sound cool. Like, you watch porn. Those guys say shit I'm not going to say. Like, I can't imagine having that much confidence during sex. Oh, I'm going to come. Give me your forehead. I can't say that shit. You know what I say when I'm gonna go, uh-oh. I need a tissue. She wouldn't let it go, though. She's, come on, I hate when you're so quiet. Just try. I'm like, I don't wanna. She's like, why not? I'm like, I don't know what to say. She's like, you can say anything. I don't care. I'm like, not you're wrong about that shit. And I feel weird having this fucking conversation right now. Say anything. Like, I was trying to think of shit to say that I could say. Like, I don't want to talk trash I can't back up. You know, like, be back there like, yeah, take that. Take fucking what? I already know. See, I'm not setting myself up for fucking one-liner here, you know? Yeah, take that without laughing. I dare you. So I was trying to think of shit to say that I could say, but now there's, you know, there's like an awkward silence, like she's waiting for me to say something and I got nothing. I was trying to think of shit that I've heard, but I panicked. The best I could come up with on the spot, I was like, I want you to come inside me. Then it was like a really long pause after that. To the point where I look over, even the Puggles, like, I don't know what you said, but you just fucked up. Where the fuck were you at on that one? You didn't have any suggestions. It seemed like forever. Like, I even started hoping, like, maybe she didn't hear that shit. Oh. Finally, I hear, what the fuck did you just say? I said, give me your forehead. Goddamn.